string of MPs call for an apology, the controversy surrounding Boris Johnson shows no sign of letting up. Today's headline, Boris Johnson is a bellend. I mean, that can make the front page any day of the year. There's nothing shocking here. Tim, our future Prime Minister has Steve Bannon on speed dial, for fuck's sake. Boris is an attention-craving twat. Boris is an attention-craving twat, they shout, giving him all the attention he craves. He's only doing this for political gain, say all the politicians who, in saying so, are in no way exploiting this for political gain. And in all of this, once again, quite a complex debate that requires consideration and nuance has been reduced to some inflammatory attempts at humour on one side and some pretty dramatic pearl clutching on the other. You know, let's take this opportunity to have this debate. Instead of interviewing people about what a prick Boris Johnson is, let's make a serious news programme, Tim, about the burqa. You know, why not? Well, all the more reason to have the fucking debate, you numpty. All right. So, some hypotheticals, okay? A liberal viewpoint. Denmark banning the burqa is a demonstration of oppression. Another liberal viewpoint. The burqa itself is a demonstration of oppression. Discuss. You know, it can be like something that Nikki Campbell would do, but with me doing it instead. Finally. You know, stuff like, is Boris Johnson describing a minority group of women as bank-robbing letterboxes and incitement to hatred? Are violent Islamophobic thugs really waiting for his permission before they strike? You know, and I want this aired at a decent time of day, Tim, not a Sunday fucking morning. That's for sure. Right. Today on the Jonathan Pye Show, we ask, is in the 21st century the hijab a symbol of women's liberation, like the iconic image of the American flag being worn as a headscarf, or is, in the 21st century, the hijab for most Muslim women across the globe a medieval religious garment which suggests that they are responsible if men ogle their naked flesh? To discuss in the studio, we have, I don't know, Gloria Hunniford. If you do believe that the burqa is one of the world's most potent symbols of patriarchal oppression, is it morally okay to agree with Denmark's ban, no matter what the government's real motivations? As with most arguments, Tim, there are a dozen permutations. Some are wrong, some are right, and most are somewhere in between. Why can't we have these discussions? Is it because they challenge, because they mean confronting uncomfortable truths, or is it simply not worth discussing because the arguments that contradict yours offend you? Here's one. Is joking about Islam Islamophobia per se? Let's ask the audience. Yeah, an audience of experts. I don't want the public anywhere near this. Okay, the public, they're fucking thick. If it's okay to make a joke about a vicar, is it okay to make a joke about an imam? You know, for centuries, we've had a global tradition of deflating religious pretensions and hypocrisy through powerful satire. Aristophanes, Erasmus, the Vicar of Dibley. We need to have this essential debate, Tim, and I need to host it. Well, since leaving the Foreign Office, obviously Boris has been free of the shackles of government.